Fantasy with hosts Mary Martin and Jim Hartz.
Oh, good group of
them.
Hello and welcome again to Over Easy. Our first guest today is one of the loveliest and most beloved stars of Hollywood, although she retired from her full-time movie career nearly 35 years ago.
Mm-hmm. And even though Alice Faye has chosen to make only a few appearances in film and on television, her fans have never forgotten her.
We'll welcome Alice Faye in just a moment. And then later on in the show, we'll take a look at the picturesque career of one of the world's most successful illustrators, Arthur Rackham, whose greatest works were done when he was well past his 70th year.
Then Jim will join Chef Narcy David in our Over Easy kitchen to show off his own skills with a skillet. And you'll have to have a pencil and a paper ready to take down their recipe.
Right now, though, we want to share a moment from one of the most delightful films ever to come out of Hollywood. It's seen from Alexander's Ragtime Band. And in addition to Tyrone Power and Don Ameche, it starred our very special guest today, Alice Faye.
Won the hearts of millions of fans in that picture, and she kept them close to her own heart all these years. Please welcome one of Hollywood's most memorable ladies, the beautiful and talented Alice Faye. To see that on film again, Alice, it just brings back so many memories. I want to weep, and do you want to weep a little bit?
I think I'm weeping.
Well, but it's a joy to have you here with us.
Oh, thank you, Mary. I'm so glad to be
here.
It's
almost a dream come true as far as I'm concerned.
Well, I'm so proud of you. I tell you, you're really something.
Just keep moving.
That's what I say. That's what we're trying to do.
Do you get to see the old movies much anymore, or are they sort of faded away?
Not really. No.
You don't really see them?
No.
I don't see mine either.
You don't?
Mm-mm.
Oh, well.
Tell us about your first screen test.
Oh, Mary.
Well, you must remember it. Now, tell us.
That's a long way back.
Well, that's all right. We've got a long time.
Well, that had a lot to do with Rudy Valley.
Yes.
And I went out to the coast with Rudy. I was singing with his band.
Mm-hmm.
And he was doing the Fleischman Hour. I guess you all remember that.
Mm-hmm.
And I was singing with the band, and he was going to do George White's Scandals.
Mm-hmm.
And he, they had some sort of difficulty there with the lady that was going to star in it. And they were looking for someone else to play the lead.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a chance to take a test. I'm cutting this short.
That's okay.
And I made the test, and God was with me, and I
and
got,
you got
the break,
the part.
And that's how I got the part.
And then you never were off the screen again?
No.
Until you decided on your own.
Until I retired.
Didn't I hear about your mother coaching you for that test in a particular
way? You wouldn't bring that up.
Tell
would
that story.
You? Tell it.
Honest?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, God, this is terrible.
No, it's not.
Really?
Well, no, I'd love to hear.
Well, anyway. Oh, this is awful. I haven't told two or three people this in my life.
Tell us.
The screen test I had to make was about a little girl that was making her debut. So I went home with my dialogue and said to Mom, this girl says, oh, I'm so excited, I'm so thrilled. This is the most beautiful night to me. I am making my, and it is D-E-B-U-T. So I said to Mother, what does that say? What does that
mean? What does that mean?
So Mom said, well, it spells D-E-B-U-T. I guess it's D-butt. So off I went to work the next morning. In the first take, the director said, now, little girl, there you are. And I said, here I am. I'm so thrilled. I'm so happy. I can't wait. I am the happiest girl in the world. I'm just going to make my debut.
That's why you got the part. Nobody else would have been better.
Well, I did it three times, and he finally said, well, now, we've had enough of you. We don't need any comedians, so... come here. So he straightened me out and said it was debut, which didn't mean much more to I didn't know what he was talking about. But that's how I...
Oh, Alice. That
you mentioned a minute ago about your retirement. You quit right at the height of your career.
Mm-hmm. Right.
What happened? What made you do that?
Well, I had been working a long time, and I was 26 years old and thought about time I had some children. And Phil Harris had been chasing me quite a while. He would like me to put it the other way. Yeah, he said, now you tell them how you were chasing me. But
I know Phil, too. I know how he would put that.
You know, so I decided I'd just quit, get married, and have a family.
And you really did quit at 26
years old? Yes, I did. I sure did.
Alice, it's hard for me to believe.
You were lured back for a couple of roles, though, later on, but nothing like the original schedule that you put in.
No. Uh-huh.
You've been married to Phil, then, nearly 40 years?
40 years next month.
Honestly? Mm-hmm. And you've been, and he was a major star in his orchestra.
Right.
And you were a major star. How did Phil and you decide to get married? To give up.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, I mean, I know he chased you, but how did you
want
him
to catch
you?
Well, he really did chase me. I didn't chase him.
I know that.
He said that I chased him.
But what made the decision final?
Oh, I don't know. I guess it was just, you know, just love at first sight.
How'd you meet?
This is embarrassing, really.
Not to us.
Well, this has to do with two Doberman pinchers. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
All right. I lived in Encino, and Phil lived in Encino, out in the valley. And we each had a dog. I didn't know him then. And he had this beautiful Doberman, and I had a Doberman. And when I went to work in the morning, my dog would take off. So this one day, my dog took off and met up with Phil's dog, and there was a terrible fight.
Mm-hmm.
And Phil Harris's dog was hurt.
Mm-hmm.
And I got a phone call. And the message was left that Phil Harris called. And I said, well, I don't know anyone by that name. And then I said, oh, yes, I do. He's the one that sings about something to eat. Remember, that's what I like about the South. Won't you come with me to Alabama?
Oh, yes, I certainly do remember
that. Let's go
see
my dear old mammy, you know? Well, anyway, he left a message that I should keep my dog at home. And I left him a message that I can't repeat. So, Mary, that's how it all started.
Well, it wasn't exactly love at first sight then.
No, not really.
Richard never had the same thing because he was the only executive at Paramount to turn down my test. He ruined the day ever since. Well, now that you've been married to Phil for 40 years, how do you keep this long-term marriage going?
Well, we travel a lot. Separately.
Oh.
His way, and I go my way. That's true, really.
Did you ever play Hello, Dolly? You go your way, and I go your way.
That's right. No, he goes shooting a lot. He goes hunting a lot. He used to go, you know, out with Bing a lot.
And mm-hmm.
He misses Bing a lot.
Oh, I'm sure he does.
But
I miss Bing
true.
A lot.
I know.
We all
do.
Yes.
Gosh, we all do.
Alice, after your movie career, you and Phil did a radio show, the Phil Harris Alice Faye Show, together on radio for a number of years. And I wonder what it was like, since both of you were sort of established stars and you had your own careers going, what it was like to work together.
Well, he's hard to work for.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Because he sort of gives the outward impression, at least on stage and pictures and so on, of being an easygoing,
That's
sort
what they
of happy-go-lucky
you know,
fellow.
Isn't it wonderful married to a funny man like that?
Yeah. Well, the last time we saw each other was in a place to eat in Palm Springs. And
that's
it was a birthday party, and
that's
Phil sang, and you sang across the
that's
table.
Right.
We
that's
all
right.
sang.
Oh,
it was a birthday
that was fun.
For Janet, I think. Janet
it was
Gaynor's,
Janet Gaynor's,
Gaynor's birthday.
Birthday. That's right.
And we all sang to her impromptu.
That's right.
It was
right.
one of the most fun nights ever, because I hadn't
we
seen
really
her
did.
In so many years. And I've known Phil since he was an orchestra leader in Dallas, Texas. I've known him.
I know that.
You have two daughters.
Two daughters.
Alice Jr. and
Alice lives
Phyllis.
In New Orleans, and yes. Phyllis lives in Tucson.
Mm-hmm.
And Alice has two beautiful boys, and Phyllis has a beautiful girl and a boy.
So you have four grandchildren.
I have four grandchildren.
Do you love being a grandmother as much as I do?
I love it.
Isn't it the best life? They come
really
to see
do.
You and stay for a while, then they go home.
I love it. I just love it. That's
just
the only way.
I've just had six with me for about 8 or 9 days.
Oh, I heard about you. And
ding-a-ling.
Weren't they on the show with you?
Yes. Oh, they were all on the show.
Oh, what a kick.
What special pleasures does it bring? And what's the difference really between being a parent and a grandparent?
Well, I think the grandparent has it made, don't you?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, sure.
They all want to come to see you.
Oh, yes.
And then they want to go home,
you can
too.
Get rid of them when you want to, too.
Yeah. No, but they are,
nah,
it's a joy.
Mine are big, though.
Have they ever had any kind of career?
Never.
Always
no.
housewives
That's
and
right.
mothers.
That's right.
Isn't that amazing?
Mm-hmm.
You have a career in painting, if you want it.
Well, I'm trying, Mary. I have to go back to it. I haven't painted in a year. It seems like, you know, when you start
She's
to paint...
She's fabulous.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no.
Yes, you
I love Janet's things. Janet's great.
Well,
Janet's
you are, too.
Well, I don't know.
Why don't you start it again?
I'm going to.
You know, Janet didn't start it until late in life, and now she's mm-hmm. had five showings.
I know. I read about
Do you ever
it.
Do needlepoint?
Lots of needlepoint.
Do you ever design them?
No.
Well, why don't you do that?
It's too hard.
Mary never thought it was.
Oh, I couldn't do that.
Yes, you could.
Oh,
Alice, you can do anything you want to if you want
really?
To.
I like to hear this, don't you? You can do anything you want
You can.
To.
I have to come to see you more often.
I need
push you. Push you a little
I need
bit.
You, Mary.
Yeah.
There's something I want to ask you, though. You look hardly different
mm-hmm.
from what we saw in Alexander's Ragtime Band. How do you stay in such good shape?
Well, I exercise a lot, like
mm-hmm.
Mary, and I swim a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I started many years ago exercising, going to Elizabeth Arden's.
Mm-hmm.
I used to tell Phil I'd rather do that twice a year than have a piece of jewelry or
mm-hmm.
something like that, which I really did. And I started doing all the exercises I see on the air now. This Richard Simmons does.
Mm-hmm.
The
I think he's marvelous.
Isn't he marvelous? I watch him every morning.
So you have a daily regimen that you
I
do?
I try to work a little bit every day.
Mm-hmm.
I really do. And it works out and it pays off, doesn't it, Mary?
Oh, absolutely. You feel better. And
right.
I bet you can do the same things you did years ago. I still can.
I can.
Still move the same movements that I did at 19. Maybe a little slower.
Almost.
But I still go up and down.
Oh, I go up and down, because sometimes I don't come up.
Yeah. One of the things that we like to discuss on Over Easy is transitions, and I wondered if you'd talk about yourself for a minute. What's the Alice Faye of today like, and how are you different from the Alice Faye that we saw in the movies in the 40s?
Oh, my gosh. I've learned a lot. And, I don't know. I keep house. I cook a lot. I love to cook.
Mm-hmm.
It's an entirely different way of living. Just entirely different.
Do you miss the other, ever?
Not really.
Would you ever come back and do something like this show?
You mean...
Or any show, just as a talk show?
I don't know that I could. I don't think I could. I envy you. I don't think I'm put together like that. I don't think I could do it. But you can do it,
you,
Alice.
You see, you have to think. You have to think you can do it, Alice.
I think I can do it.
You've been a singer and an actress and a mother and a grandmother, and you've mastered every one of those roles. So why can't you master another one, Alice?
I hear you, Mary. I don't have an answer, and I haven't had an offer.
Well, if you have an offer, I'm going to be there to make you answer properly.
Oh,
I can't
Mary.
Tell you how many people love seeing you. You don't know how much you're loved, honestly.
Oh,
truly loved.
I really
mean, you
do.
Can go into a restaurant and people just, you know, fall by the wayside because they think there's Alice Faye. This is the truth.
Absolutely.
Isn't that so?
One final question, one we always try to ask our guests, too. Even though you've been through these marvelous stages in your life, what are your goals now? What do you look forward to?
You wouldn't believe it.
Well, I'm
Try me.
Let's hear.
Like to rob a bank.
That'll get you in pictures.
That'll get me in pictures.
That'll get you in pictures in post offices.
Oh,
that's what it'll get you.
But be
Wanna
sure
to come with me?
Yeah, naturally.
Right.
Rob a big one.
Oh, I am.
While you're at
it. I've got to. The tops.
I know they've already made those pictures, but they've never had a lady, have they?
No. See, they had George Burns just did it. I thought.
Why not?
Why not?
I think we'll save that fantasy to our next appearance. Would you come back and see us?
Oh, I'd love
soon?
To.
Would you, honest?
Really, honest.
Okay.
It's
honest,
been a
Mary.
All right.
And you're very dear to have me.
Well, we're thrilled to death. It's our pleasure.
Ladies and gentlemen, Alice Pratt.